Today we will discuss ground stabilized and sea stabilized. So radar can be either ground stabilized or sea stabilized. So we can select, we want to keep it ground stabilized or sea stabilized. So which is a better stabilized method? Now first, it should be clear, radar is used for anti-collision as well as for position plot, position monitoring, which is anti-grounding. If we are using radar for anti-grounding, for example, ship's course, gyro course north 000, there's a lighthouse or a piece of land here, we take bearing and distance, let's say 045, and we plot it on the chart. So this way radar is being used for anti-collision, anti-grounding. In this case, we can keep the radar on sea stabilized or ground stabilized, it does not matter, because we will get the same bearing and distance from the lighthouse or the piece of land. Now, whenever you keep the radar to ground stabilized, then GPS gets connected to the radar. And speed lock is not connected to the radar. But when you keep the radar on sea stabilized, then GPS is not connected to the radar and speed lock gets connected to the radar. So in this case, for anti-grounding, you can keep it on ground or sea, anything, doesn't matter. But suppose you are using a radar for anti-collision and you are also using ARPA because you want to find out the course and speed of a target ship. In this case, you have to keep it to sea stabilized. Now, when you keep it to sea stabilized, speed lock gets connected to the radar, GPS is not connected. So when ARPA calculates the course and speed of the target vessel, you will get the gyro course of the target vessel and its speed through the water, that is its lock speed. And gyro course of target vessel is required for collision avoidance, because your rules of the road ROR is based on gyro course of the target vessel. But in case you connect ground stabilized to the radar, speed lock is not connected and ARPA will calculate and give you the GPS course instead of gyro course. It will give you the GPS course of the other vessel, which is not required for collision avoidance. So that is the reason we keep radar sea stabilized when we are wanting to find out the course and speed of the target vessel. If you just want to find out CPA, you can keep it to ground stabilized or sea stabilized, you will get the same CPA, but course and speed will be different. Let's see how. Normally, ships have got two radars. Let's keep one radar on ground stabilized, one on sea stabilized. So this is on ground stabilized. Own ship steering gyro course 000 north. And there's a target ship which you have acquired coming head on. And the other radar is sea stabilized. Own ship steering 000. Head on, say around 6 miles off, you have acquired one target by ARPA. This is sea stabilized. Now, if your ship is going 000 north and the target ship is steering a gyro course of 180, once you acquire this target, in the window you will get a gyro course of the target vessel, which will be 180, and you come to know that this vessel is coming down If you select relative vector, it will show like this. Her true vector will also show like this. So it's a head-on situation. So then you can go as per rules of the road, alter to starboard, and she will also alter to starboard. But here, in case there is a current like this, westerly, and you acquire this target here, and let's say it is fog, restricted visibility, visually you can't see this vessel, which is, let's say, 6 miles off, and you select true vector, you might get a true vector like this, because this could be the GPS course of the other vessel. And since you can't see the other vessel, you might think this is a crossing situation. Actually, it is a head-on situation. Her true vector in this case will be same, like here, because on the screen she will be moving like this. But her true vector will be like this. And in the window here, you might get the course of the target ship, something like, if you read out here, 160. And so this is the reason we keep the radar on sea stabilized when you want to find out the course and speed of the target vessel.